Hey you guys, thanks for hanging out with me today. I am so excited for today's video because most of my things from the Aritzia Clientele sale of 2022, which happened about a month ago, finally came in, and I'm just missing one item, but everything else came in. So I thought I should probably just make this video instead of having to wait for the other item to come in. I'm extra excited for some of these items because I've been waiting for them to come in so that I can wear during this hot summer month of July. There's quite a few things. I didn't think that I ordered this much stuff, but you know, I should have known. Some of the things here are repeat items because I did buy some styles in multiple colors because of how much I love them. That is a true testament of how much I love these pieces. Before we jump into the try-on haul, I wanted to thank STYLEVANA for collaborating with me on this portion of the video. A huge thank you goes to them for always helping me stock up on my beloved Korean skincare. You guys already know how passionate I am about anti-aging and skincare in general, so I am so happy to collaborate with them again. Okay, so let's go ahead and dig into some of the Korean beauty products that STYLEVANA kindly provided me to feature in today's video. And I'm gonna start off with a bang. I was so excited to get this in the package. You guys, oh my gosh, I love Dr. Jart. Dr. Jart is one of my favorite skincare brands of all time. This is their Vital Hydra Solution Sheet Facial Mask. And I haven't tried this specific one, but I have tried Dr. Jart's other facial masks. Dr. Jart is a really great Korean skincare brand if you have any dryness or sensitivity. I've tried their sheet masks that are in the yellow packaging, which is my favorite because I use that whole line of skincare. I actually use their nighttime moisturizer as well as their toner, and I absolutely love it. I think honestly that is the product that I'm the most excited about. Also, I got something from Etude, which is also a Korean skincare brand and makeup brand. And this is their Sunjung 2x Barrier Intensive Cream. I've heard so many good things about this line of skincare products. It seems like a really nourishing and hydrating cream for the face, so I'm super excited to try this. You guys already know I love sunscreen. Sunscreen is life. I wear it every single morning. This is the Frutia Avocado Greenery Relief Sun Cream in SPF 50. I wear sunscreen religiously and go through sunscreen so quickly because it is one of those products that I go through really, really quickly because I use it on my face, my neck, my décolleté, my arms. I have tried their SPF before and it is so hydrating and soft and makes your skin look really plump. So I really, really love this brand for SPF. This I'm really excited about. It's the Isn't Tree Real Rose Calming Mask, and it is a intense, moisture gel formula with real rose leaf and rose water, soothes irritated skin, which I need because my skin is always irritated. This is definitely gonna help out in that department. They included a serum from Toradin? Some of these names, it's a little harder than others. This is their low molecular hyaluronic acid with deep panthenol, and I love these hydrating serums because they are just really good underneath moisturizers, right before makeup application. It just helps everything go on way more smoothly. This is an exciting one. This is like a big box of skincare. It's by Make Prem. This was like a really fancy box with some fun skincare. It has like the ingredients on this sheet. This includes a low irritant and mild acidic foam, which is their cleansing foam. The one in the middle is another SPF, which I'm gonna be all about. And their sample size of the cleansing milk. Super excited to try some of the stuff from this brand. I don't think I've ever tried anything by them before. I can't remember. Definitely will give you guys my thoughts after I use them for a little bit. Super excited to try all of these really exciting Korean skincare goodies. Hope you guys check them out too. I'll leave all the links to everything below. I think I also have a coupon code, so I'll go ahead and leave that here as well so you guys can get a few dollars off. That is everything from STYLEVANA. Thank you again so much for gifting me all these lovely products and collaborating with me on this portion of the video. Now let's go ahead and get back to the try-on haul. Let's go ahead and get started with the pair of jeans that I bought. I was so excited for this because I have never tried Ogoldi jeans, but I have heard so much rave around this brand. Everyone talks about how comfortable they are and how they've changed their lives. Like, it's crazy. It has like a cult following. It's so funny because at the beginning of the sale, I actually placed multiple orders to get the Ogoldi jeans in several different colorways and styles, but I ultimately decided to cancel them and stuck with just one pair of Ogoldi jeans. And it is the Riley jean. It is in the size 24, and 24 fits me pretty well, so I went with my true size. Sizing in Ogoldi jeans is so complicated. Everyone is like all over the place. Like, it's so hard to find the size, but I actually decided to go into the store and try these on before I stuck with the order. So I'm glad that I did. I was going to get a 25 because I did hear that they run small, and I'm so glad that I didn't get the 25 because it would have been really big on me. The 24s are perfect. My normal size is around the 24 or 25. These have the little rips at the knees, and it's a really pretty kind of light blue wash. It has a button-up fly, and I do really enjoy the look of these jeans. I will say it does make your butt look really nice, and I love the length on these on me. I am on the shorter side, and these fall kind of right around my ankles, which is what I love. I love the fit and the style. I love how the legs are kind of more of a straight leg, but my issue with these is that they're just not very comfortable. I don't know what people are saying about the comfort level of these, because I was let down. I was very disappointed, actually. Now I am hesitant to buy more Ogoldi jeans because they just didn't live up to the hype, and maybe it's because everyone hyped it up so much that my expectations were really high. I was disappointed because these are not cheap. I bought them on sale, but they were still not cheap. I think I paid about $140 on sale. I think they run for about $180 to $200 retail price. So they are expensive, and they weren't that comfortable. But they do look really good on. I'll give it to them. But in terms of comfort and flexibility wise, like, it really doesn't have a lot of give. Just wasn't what I was expecting. Let me know in the comments if you guys would actually be interested in a denim throwdown kind of video where I kind of give you guys my thoughts on the best denim brands based on my own personal experiences, because I think that'd be a really fun video. I am going to give you a little bit of a spoiler alert that I love my Levi's jeans. They're just so much more comfortable than the Ogoldi jeans. I'm gonna say it, and I don't know, I've only tried one pair of jeans from Ogoldi, so I won't judge them too hard right now, too prematurely, but those are my thoughts as of right now. The next item I want to show you guys is a pair of trousers from Aritzia. This is the Dashwood pant in size 2 in the color Frozen Gray. And I specifically got this pair of trousers because of Rachel on YouTube. I saw her in these pants and I fell in love. I think it looks so good on her, and I decided to get one for myself. I think this color is so beautiful. It has these cuffs at the ankle, and I do think that I got this in a short version because I am short. These are definitely a little bit different than the Effortless pant, which I also own and bought from the sale, but I got their cropped version, so it does look quite different on me than the regular Effortless pant. I like both the Dashwood and Effortless styles, but I gotta say this one does look like a true pant on me, which I actually like the look of. So it just gives off a different vibe, and I think this is a little bit more formal, but it does have an elastic band, which is really comfortable to wear. In the future, I definitely would have picked up a black color as well, because I'm a neutrals kind of girl, so I need them in several different colors, especially the black, white, and beige colorways. Speaking of neutrals, I got another pair of shorts, and this is from the Babaton line. These are a more formal looking shorts option, and they are 7 inches. In hindsight, I wish that I grabbed them in the 5-inch length because they do look a little bit long on me. My thought process when picking these up in a 7-inch was because I was like, oh, it'll be more, I don't know, work appropriate because it's longer than my fingertips and it's not like booty shorts, you know. But in hindsight, I should have grabbed the 5-inch because I'm so short that the 7-inch length looks a little awkward on me. Whatever, it is what it is, but I still love them. And I think these are a great option if you work in the office and you still want to be a little bit more modest but still show a little leg. It is a little risky in some office settings, like not risky, but you know, it's not appropriate in some settings to wear shorts. But if your workplace is a little bit more lenient but you want to dress a little bit more formal, then I think these trouser type shorts are an amazing style to go for. The next two things are in the one piece category. This one is a dress from the Wilfred Free line. This was actually on clearance, so it was pretty affordable. It's just a very simple ribbed dress, and it's like the best like summer mini dress. I will say though, I don't wear this when I'm feeling bloated because it does show everything. The fabric is super thin and I have to wear nude underwear and nude bra with this because it is quite see-through, but I love this color and it's really cute. If I go for color, it is going to be a pastel or like a very light color, as you can tell from this dress and the dashwood pant that I showed you in the frozen gray. I don't know. I like to go for lighter colors if I do want to venture out and actually wear a color that's not black, white, gray, beige, nude, brown. You get the gist. I just wanted to add this to my collection as an effortless kind of throw on dress to run errands. And yeah, I just think this is really cute and you can also dress it up if you'd like. The fabric is so soft on this. I love it. The next thing is a... what is this? A play suit? A jumper? A romper? I don't know, all those interchangeable words, right? I think they called it the market jumpsuit or something, and this is in the color basalt gray. It is just a really nice kind of slinky material. It's super stretchy, and I'm so excited to wear this, guys. I think this is one of the most exciting pieces that I have from this haul, actually. It is very, very flowy, has these like wide leg flowy pant all the way down. It hits right above my ankle, I would say. And I'm just so excited to wear this because first off, it is going to be so comfortable. And I love this color. I have a pretty big kick for gray right now, which you can see the frozen gray, the basalt gray, and I have a shirt on that's gray. I'm on a kick for gray. So I'm just so excited to wear this. I think this is just so stinking cute. I think you can just like throw this on and hang out and lounge in it at the comfort of your own home, or you can wear it out. So super excited for that. The next two things are tops, and I'm actually wearing this one right now, which is one of my favorite t-shirts or tops from Aritzia. This is just a really nice ribbed material. I have this in several different colors. I think I have a black, a white, now this gray, and then I have a brown. So I have like 4 in total, I think. And it's because I just wear these so much and it's such good quality. It's so comfortable. It's not too tight, but it's definitely not like a relaxed fit or anything like that. It does kind of conform to your body. It just kind of goes with every outfit and it's a really good basic to have. I've upgraded all of my low quality t-shirts to this and this other shirt that I'm going to show you, which is a great segue to this one. This is the relaxed hip something t-shirt. And I have this in an extra small, and as you can see, this is definitely a very much more of a relaxed, loose fit. These two are the main two shirts that I'll go for if I want to go for like a casual look. The structure of this relaxed t-shirt is amazing. It just looks like an elevated version of a t-shirt. Even if it is a very simple top, it just looks elegant. I don't know how to explain it. I think this is honestly like my definition of a perfect t-shirt. It's so comfortable, super soft, and I bought this in multiple colors. If you are on a hunt for a really nice t-shirt and you kind of want to upgrade your basics and your wardrobe, I would highly recommend this. This is a kind of relaxed button-up shirt. It's in this strawberry color as well. It's from the Wilfred line. If you've seen my last Aritzia haul, part one of the Clientele sale, you will have seen that I bought this in a blue color, which I am still obsessed with. But how cute is this pink? I just love throwing this on over a mini top as kind of a cover-up situation. You can also use this as a beach cover-up over your bikini at the beach. It's just so effortless and chic. I love these tops. You can also wear it as an actual top. There's just so many ways to wear this. I think it is a true workhorse in your wardrobe, so highly recommend these types of button-ups. And this fabric is just amazing. I don't like the stiff, starchy linen. I actually like my linen blouses to be a little bit more free-flowing and unstructured, so this was the perfect go-to for me. All right, last but not least, we have something very weather inappropriate. Definitely not gonna be wearing this for the next few months, but I did pick up a leather jacket from Aritzia because the sale on this was crazy. I think it was 50% off. There were only a few left in the size extra small, so I grabbed it and I'm really glad that I did. It is quite oversized though, so it does give off that boyfriend style feel, I guess, but I still love it. The material is so good and you can tell it's really well made and high quality. So I didn't have a beige type of leather jacket, so definitely wanted to grab these while they were on sale. So excited to style these for the fall. Oh my gosh, it's gonna be great. I know some of you guys are diehard summer fans, like summer fashion fans, but I gotta admit, I love my fall fashion. All right, that is it, you guys. Thanks so much for watching this video and hanging out with me today. All the links and sizing information will be down below in the comments and description box. Please like this video if you haven't already, subscribe if you want to stick around, and I will talk to you guys in the comments. Bye.